Hi, this is Dr. Damon Miller, your Organic MD.
And this is Carlisle Koash. Welcome to OrganicMD.com and our video cast here on our YouTube channel. This is part three of a three-part series we're doing on retinitis pigmentosa.
Yeah, and today we're going to be talking about some of the things we know about treatment of retinitis pigmentosa. And this is going to be different than what you hear about from your ophthalmologist, what you hear about in the news.
Why is that?
Well, that's a good question, Carlisle. That's a good question. You know, these things that we do have been in the news. You know, there's been on Today's Show. It's been in Townsend Letter, in given a number of scientific presentations at conferences. But, you know, this is just not mainstream. And so even when a story shows up and people are really amazed for a few days, but it has a very short news cycle, as they say. And so the stories don't just get spread around and stay alive for weeks and months. So, but our job is to just let you know that there is another story out there, especially if you are suffering from one of these diseases and you're tired of hearing your ophthalmologist tell you that there's nothing that can be done, because there is something that can be done, and we're here to tell you what that is. So the you know, the one thing that even the ophthalmologists talk about, they talk about the
value. You sounded a little like Groucho Marx there for a second.
Thank you. Yes, very good. You know, there are the vitamins that are used and things, but, you know, please realize that years, decades of research have looked at the use of vitamins and supplements and all kinds of mixes and different products for these diseases, retinitis pigmentosa, macular degeneration, Stargardt disease. And the best that's ever been shown is that using supplements alone will slow the progression of the disease. Your eyes will continue to get worse, just not quite as quickly. They will not stop the disease. They will not reverse it. There is no supplement or combination of supplements that's ever been shown to bring a lasting halt to the progression of the disease or to bring any kind of lasting recovery. You've got to do more. And we're going to outline briefly what we know what that more is. And I just want to say, you know, if you're really interested in this, Carlisle and I just put a book out called Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes. And it's available on Amazon.com. There's a Kindle version, a large print paperback version. You really want to get that if you want the detail on this. And there's also a lot of material at OrganicMD.com. But beside the vitamins, we're really, you know, we titled the book Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes because we've come to understand that this work we've been doing for decades where we've seen people get better, the reason these therapies allow people to get better is they engage the system of adult stem cells that we were all born with, that we all carry around with us everywhere we go, the system that is now understood that I don't care if it's a major injury or you just cut yourself shaving, it's your adult stem cells that are engaged to heal that wound, even if it's just a cut on your leg or your face, heal that wound so that things grow back and look the way they did before they were injured. It's stem cells that do that. And those same stem cells, those same adult stem cells that, you know, we're not buying as a product, nobody's injecting them into us, we have them, those can be engaged to help regenerate your eye. Those can be engaged to help regenerate your eye.
You know, actually, it's in a sense that some of the supplements that are the most effective are ones that actually help stimulate that.
Yeah, there's one
along with diet.
One supplement we use that leads to an increased amount of circulating stem cells. The adult stem cells hang out mostly in the bone marrow, and their day job, if you want to call it that, is they make blood cells, they make white cells, red cells, platelets, all these kinds of things. But when needed, there are signals that can come from areas of injury that can cause those cells to release, go into the bloodstream, and they sniff out the area of injury and engage in the repair of that. It's complex how that works. We talk about that in the book. But one of the problems when you have a chronic injury or a chronic degenerative process where there's no real inflammation, that all the things that would trigger and stimulate that system are missing. The inflammation plays a role in that. And so that's where things like the, especially the microcurrent stimulation, seem to play a role in calling and signaling to those adult stem cells. And, you know, this work with microcurrent stimulation, two pieces that I think it's important to include in this little talk here. One is that it isn't the be-all and end-all.
Like the other things. I mean, they're all...
Yeah. I mean, Grace Halloran...
There's one part.
Grace Halloran, who started this work back in the 70s, trying to treat her own son and her family. She had a familial form of this. she was getting great results with people for 10 years before she ever introduced microcurrent stimulation. And if all you did was get a decent microcurrent stimulator and treat yourself, you probably wouldn't get very good results. It's got to be a holistic approach. And that's with a, you know, holism in the sense of treating all of the parts of your health. But the microcurrent stimulation does help. It makes things happen faster. But the other part about microcurrent stimulation is that it, you know, I first read about it in the 70s. There were articles where orthopedic surgeons who were helping develop this, they were actually amputating legs off of animals and getting them to regrow. And, you know, this was before I was ever involved in the eye. It was before I was ever even in medical school. And I was tearing these articles out of the journal Science and Nature and Scientific American going, this is amazing. You know, if you can regrow a limb, you've cut off an animal, what can't you do? And that, all that research still stands. You know, no one disputes it. It's quite elegant and amazing research. And so we just harness the power of that to help regenerate your eyes. Again, we have this book that we publish, Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes. It really lays it out in more detail. But
and just to add too, that one of the components that we've added into the program that's now a very strong component, I suppose it always has been in some respects, but I think we've made it more formal,
yes,
is really addressing the nutrition and the diet aspect. There's this way in which if your body, you talked about inflammation, so if your body is just always inflamed because your diet isn't very good, you're not taking very good care, then those stem cells don't even know where to find the things that really need healing, because everything is, it's like the red lights are on everywhere. And so,
yeah, we made that healthy eating workshop mandatory for everybody in our eye program, the Better Eye Health program, because it, you know, there are a lot of people who eat what looks like a very good diet, but the kind of magic thing that you need to understand is food sensitivities. If you're eating foods that your body doesn't like, they could be really great foods, beautiful foods, organic, really great food for somebody else. But if it's not a good food for you, it's another source of inflammation. And so eating a good diet becomes a very complex subject, you know, because it's a good diet for you. It may not be a good diet for somebody else, but it's got to be what's a good diet for you. And so that's what we do now as part of that module in the program. And I just, I think I'm going to end it there. You know, this is a program that works, the Better Eye Health program. It's a program that works, but only if you do it. And so it's one of those, just try it.
Like so many things in life.
Yeah, just try it. You know, it's safe, it's easy, and, you know, it'll work for you and will work with you. So this is the last of the talks on retinitis pigmentosa. We'll be doing additional talks down the road. Stay tuned, maybe subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to be getting notices when we put new videos up.
So thank you, and we really appreciate you spending time and listening to this. And as always, if you have ideas or suggestions, let us know, and we'll talk to you soon.
Yeah, and just remember, there is hope for sight. There is hope for sight. Thank you.